Embedded designs consist of multiple serial protocols and components that require deeper analysis. Learn how to fully characterize your embedded or mixed signal designs to find any errors that could disrupt your device's performance. Hi, I'm Erin East with Keysight, and in this video, you'll learn how to test and debug your embedded designs. This includes protocol triggering and decoding for I2C, SPI, UART RS-232, I2S, and USB PD, also known as USB power delivery. The primary reason you should use an oscilloscope to debug and characterize embedded serial buses is because of an oscilloscope's inherent ability to characterize the analog quality of the signal. It also allows you to time-correlate serial activity with other analog and digital I/O signals in your design. Today's embedded designs based on microcontrollers and digital signal processors often include a combination of real-world analog signals, digital I/O buses, and serial buses. Although microcontrollers and DSPs are often thought of as simply digital control and processing devices, most MCUs and DSPs today are mixed signal devices. I2C, SPI, and UART RS-232 are often used for chip-to-chip communication between MCUs and memory chips, as well as other peripherals. There are many helpful capabilities in the InfiniVision oscilloscopes that allow you to debug easier and faster, like the hardware-based serial decoding for responsiveness, the dual-bus time-interleave protocol Lister display, digital channels for mixed signal analysis, the ability to capture a long time span of packets in detail with segmented memory, and a real-time frame error counter. You can test all buses in your embedded design and mixed signal designs with the InfiniVision embedded software package. This also allows you to perform pass-fail mask testing, frequency response analysis, and enhanced HDTV video triggering. I mentioned the hardware-based decoding. This is contrary to the software decoding that you'll find in other oscilloscopes from other vendors. Because there's a dedicated hardware component for the serial decoding, you're basically decoding in real time. There's no lag in responsiveness like what you would see with software decoding from other vendors. Hardware decoding is significantly faster, and this means that you're more likely to capture rare errors and random glitches. So let's take a look at the scope and how to set up serial decoding. This setup process is generally the same for every type of serial bus. To start out, of course, you have to probe on your device. Right now, I'm probing on an I2C bus and its clock. But we see there's no decoding on screen and we don't have a stable trigger. First and foremost, you have to tell the oscilloscope you want to perform serial decoding. Once you have serial turned on, set the mode to whichever bus type you're decoding. Notice in the decoding bar, the data is in various colors and formats. If you hold down the mode button, you can see the meanings of each of those symbols, hex values, or colors. Next, define the signal that you're trying to decode. In this case, I mentioned we're working with a serial clock and the I2C data. To enable the I2C trigger and decoding, along with other embedded buses and analysis options, you can download the free trial of the embedded software package from the website linked on screen or in the description. So now that we're all set up to decode that serial bus, we have to set a stable trigger. To trigger on various events within the bus, turn on the serial trigger and choose what to trigger on. Depending on the trigger you select, specify the address or the data that you wish to analyze further. And note that you can actually use the zone triggering capability to isolate various parts of the serial bus as well. So now we have a very stable trigger and can analyze the data in each packet. The Lister allows you to navigate through each packet or strings of packets with details on timing, the address, and the data. If you have to further analyze specific trigger events or packets, the standard segmented memory capability can be used to capture up to 1,000 events. This can be done with any serial mode, including those on the digital MSO channels. So let's look at this four-wire SPI decode with the trigger set on the MOSI and MISO data. Using segmented memory, we've captured 600 trigger events. By scrolling through each event in the Lister or sidebar, you can see the MOSI and MISO data. Each click on the different lister row or timestamp will show that specific section of the data on screen, including the decode information. To learn more about what segmented memory is and how to set it up, check out my What is Oscilloscope Segmented Memory video on our Keysight Labs YouTube channel. Also, remember that you can probe your mixed signal designs as well and view both the digital and analog signals at the same time. Doing so turns your oscilloscope into an MSO, a mixed signal oscilloscope. An MSO is a hybrid test instrument that combines the measurement capabilities of a digital storage oscilloscope, a DSO, with the important aspects of a logic analyzer or serial protocol bus analyzer. This means that you can view up to 4 analog signals and 16 digital signals simultaneously. And this is all being done in hardware, so the update rate remains uncompromised. You'll continue to see an incredibly fast response of up to 1 million waveforms per second. On most other oscilloscopes with software decoding, turning on these digital channels will cause your update rate to drop significantly, causing you to miss important signal events. And lastly, you can also simultaneously analyze 2 types of serial buses using the dual bus time interleaved decoding. To initiate this, you simply turn on 2 serial bus types when you're setting up the serial options. Set up each bus to the specified mode and set your trigger. With this, you can see if a bus is triggering the appropriate events in another bus, or you can view the timing of events between 2 buses. I also mentioned that the embedded software package enables a few advanced analysis capabilities as well, such as mask testing, frequency response analysis, and HDTV video triggering. If you need to validate the quality and stability of your components or systems, the mask testing capability can save you time and provide pass-fail statistics almost instantly. Mass testing offers a fast and easy way to test your signal to specified standards, as well as the ability to uncover unexpected signal anomalies, such as glitches. Mass testing on other oscilloscopes is usually based on software-intensive processing technology, which tends to be slow, much like the software decoding that you learned about. With mass testing being performed in hardware on the InfiniVision oscilloscopes, you can test up to 270,000 real-time waveform pass-fail tests per second. This makes your testing throughput orders of magnitude faster than what you could achieve on other oscilloscope software mask testing. The creation of the mask is simple with the auto mask function or the option to upload custom masks. You can also download multi-region masks and setup based on your industry standards from our website. Frequency response analysis, or FRA, is often a critical measurement used to characterize the frequency response of a variety of today's electronic designs, including passive filters, amplifier circuits, and negative feedback networks in switch mode power supplies, or the loop response. The frequency domain measurement capability is achieved with a swept gain and phase measurement versus frequency. This is also known as a Bode plot. The InfiniVision oscilloscope uses the scope's built-in waveform generator to simulate the circuit under test at various frequency settings, and then it captures the input and output signals using 2 channels of the oscilloscope. At each test frequency, the scope measures, computes, and plots the gain logarithmically and the phase linearly. And lastly, whether you're debugging consumer electronics with HDTV or characterizing a design, the enhanced HDTV video triggering and analysis provides support for a variety of HDTV standards. This enhanced video measurement capability supports a video IRE display grid with cursor measurements performed in the video IRE units for NTSC and PAL standards. In addition, the enhanced video analysis provides an array of additional HDTV triggering standards that will help you speed up debug and characterization. You can see how the plethora of embedded decodes and analysis capabilities enable you to fully characterize your embedded and mixed signal designs. Using functions like the segmented memory, the MSO options, and dual bus time interleaved decoding, you're able to analyze various events simultaneously. Furthermore, you can analyze the other components of your embedded design, such as the switch mode power supply or any filters, with the Keysight InfiniVision exclusive frequency response analysis capability. The unmatched hardware-based mask testing and segmented memory capabilities allow you to dive even deeper into the analysis. Download a free trial of the InfiniVision embedded software package that goes with your oscilloscope and learn more about it by checking out the link on screen or in the description. As always, place any questions in the comments section below and stay up to date with the latest how-to videos by clicking subscribe on our YouTube channel and following us on Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter.